This video is about rules and regulations, and I hope that doesn't make you want to stop. I think this is very important to hear, and I'm just going to start by saying there are a lot of rules and regulations associated with beekeeping. That's number one. But number two, those vary significantly based on where you live. I live in Florida. This video series is being produced from the University of Florida. There's a whole lot of rules and regulations about Florida beekeeping. This is not a video about Florida beekeeping. This is simply a video about making you aware of the types of rules and regulations you might encounter as a beekeeper. Make no mistake, it's your responsibility as the beekeeper to be aware of those rules and regulations and also to follow those rules and regulations. So hopefully I can shed a little bit of light for you on the types of things that you have to consider as you get into beekeeping. For example, there may be a regulatory authority that regulates beekeeping where you live, and they might require beekeeping or business registration. So you just have to make them aware, maybe even pay a registration fee. There could also be apiary location registration, where you have to tell some sort of regulatory authority where you're putting your bees, just so they can be aware of your bees are in case there's an incident that they need to notify you about or something that they need to follow up with you. A lot of those rules and regulations regarding to registering your apiary or registering your beekeeping business or as a beekeeper are intimately tied to apiary inspection. In the United States, for example, the state inspection laws vary by state. Here in Florida, we have a very robust apiary inspection section where you have to keep your bees registered with the state. The apiary inspectors will come and inspect your colonies yearly, specifically looking for American foul brood or perhaps some unwanted subspecies or stocks of honeybees. And that theme, that idea of inspection, varies pretty significantly by state. Some states don't have those regimented rules, some states do, and it might also occur for you if you're outside the United States. And while we're talking about apiary location, that could be regulated by a governmental authority in the U.S., for example, the state or maybe the county, but it could also be regulated by something you weren't expecting. I know, for example, homeowners associations often don't allow beekeepers to keep colonies if you live in that homeowners association. So you just need to be aware of the rules associated with placing bee colonies somewhere. Some regulatory authorities require you to follow BMPs or BMRs, which stands for Best Management Practices or Best Management Requirements. These ideas or these are the things that you would follow if you are keeping bees in a very populated area. For example, making sure that you control swarming in your colony so your bees aren't going and populating other people's trees or the walls of their houses. There also may be requirements to have identification numbers on every colony or in every apiary. Maybe you have to put your name and address and phone number on a placard beside your apiary. In the event something happens, people can find who the responsible beekeeper is and ensure that they get to you. There are usually rules and regulations associated with moving bees. Oftentimes, these rules are born out of the state or the provincial apiary inspectors. But in the United States, for example, those would be regulations about moving bees between states, say from Florida to Georgia or from Georgia to California. Those, again, would be housed under your apiary inspection program, but if you live outside the United States, there's probably some responsible governmental authority for laying out the framework associated with moving bees within that country. And while we're talking about moving bees, you need to be very aware that there are rules and regulations associated with moving bees, even dead honeybees, between countries, and so you need to be aware of those as well. So let's transition from beekeeping to the other areas that our industry can be regulated, and we'll fall next on bee removal. If you keep bees, someone is going to reach out to you and ask you to perform a removal. You all know someone who has a honeybee colony nesting in someone's tree, in their water meter box, in the wall of their house, perhaps their chimney, and you've become the resident expert that they're going to lean on to provide these services for them. So as you go up to that colony to perform that removal service, you need to be aware that the act of removing bees is considered pest control in some places around the United States and maybe even the world. So physically removing colonies from a structure of someone's house, you may be performing a pest control service, And if you do that, you may need to be insured and licensed. So just be aware of that before you take that phone call to go help someone by removing a bee colony for them. What other rules and regulations might there be? Well, if you keep your bee colony strong and healthy, then they're going to be productive, assuming that you live in an area where there's lots of nectar-producing plants, which means you're going to end up with honey that you want to extract, process, bottle, give away, or maybe even sell. You might not be surprised to find out that there's this whole assortment of rules and regulations associated with bottling, handling, and selling honey. And you want to be aware of those so that you can ensure that your bottling and selling honey enterprise is in compliance. This idea leads to my next thought. If you are keeping bees for a business, you can bet there's rules and regulations associated with all aspects of the business. People management, taxes, employment, honey house, all of these different things that you're going to have to consider as you keep bees. So how do you find out what the rules and regulations are regarding beekeeping in your area? Well, first, lean on our trusty friend Google. Sometimes it helps to Google, for example, keeping bees in Alachua County, Florida, and you might find rules and regulations. You almost certainly have a local bee scientist or bee expert, extension specialist, or a local county extension office if you're in the U.S., where there's someone who will know those rules and regulations and can point you to the right place. You might have a state, provincial, or country Department of Agriculture that is intimately familiar with the rules and regulations associated with keeping bees. Finally, just consider reaching out to other beekeepers. They've been there, they've done that, they've navigated these rules and regulations, they know what they have to do, and they would gladly tell you what you should do to make sure that your beekeeping operation's in compliance. I know this is one of those scary videos that people get really nervous about hearing, but really I just want you to have a happy, enjoyable beekeeping experience, and you'll do that if you're following the rules and regulations to ensure that your bee colonies and your beekeeping endeavor is in compliance. Thank you.